So today also we'll continue with the same chapter which we have started last class, isn't it? So that chapter number 5, major crops. So in the last class, in the previous class, we had learned about the difference between the food crop and the cash crop, isn't it? So food crops are mostly meant for self-consumption and the cash crops are meant for selling, isn't it? So today we'll take up only the food crops, that's a major food crops grown in the world. So they are wheat, rice, millets and maize. So now we'll take up the first food crop, that is wheat. Point number one, it is a temperate crop. That means it's a crop which is grown in the temperate countries, or you can say the mid-latitude region. Number two, it is grown in winter season. Number three, it requires cool climate with moderate rainfall. You can see here, cool, as we have already said, grown in winter season. So therefore, it needs cool climate with moderate rainfall. The temperature around 20 to 24 degrees Celsius and a moderate rainfall of 50 to 70 centimeters. Okay, so that you can check it in the textbook on page 53. Then let's see the leading producers. So USA, Canada, Argentina, Russia, Ukraine and India are the leading producers of wheat in the world. And in India, it is grown in the northern part of the country, especially in the states like Punjab, Haryana and Uttar Pradesh. So now let's take the second important, the staple food crop of the people. That's rice. So it is a tropical and subtropical crop. That means grown in the tropical and the subtropical countries. It requires high humidity and rainfall ranging between 100 to 200 centimeters. Now what do you mean by humidity? It's the amount of water vapor present in the air. So humidity and rainfall is both high. So high humidity and rainfall ranging between 100 to 200 centimeters. Then the areas where they are grown or where rice is grown are China, India, Japan and Sri Lanka. And in India, West Bengal is the largest producer of rice. Okay, so if you are asked, name the largest state producing rice in India is West Bengal. So this is the brief description about the rice. And one thing you have to know, mostly rice is a crop which is grown in the summer season because it requires little higher or heavy rainfall, around 100 to 200, or you can say around 300 centimeters. Now let's go to the third food crop, that's a millets. Okay, so often we call it as a coarse food grain. Okay, and there are three types of millets. Here you can see Jawar, Bajra and Ragi. So this makes up the millet. Okay, so it is grown in the semi-arid tropics of Asia and Africa. Now semi-arid means is the semi-dry regions of Asia and Africa. That means it doesn't require much water or rainfall for its growth. They are hardy crops. As I underline, yeah, hardy means, so why they are known as hardy? They can survive in the region receiving very less rainfall and they can even grow in infertile soil. Okay, so that's why they are known as a hardy crop. The next point is they are known as a kharif crop. Now what's the meaning of kharif? It is a summer crop. That means it is grown during the summer season, but they can grow in the region receiving less rainfall. That's why they are known as a hardy crops. Then India is the largest producer of millets. Okay, then we have the last food crop, that is maize, also known as a corn, and it's mostly grown in Americas as a food and a fodder crop. That is as a food also, and also the crop for the food for animals as a fodder crop. It requires warm climate. Now let us see the temperature and rainfall condition of maize. You can refer page 54 of your textbook. So the temperature between 21 to 28 degrees Celsius, and it also requires moderate rainfall and large amount of water, and it's grown in the well-drained fertile soil. Okay, then let us see the leading producer. USA, China are the largest producer of maize in the world. So these are the four major types of food crops grown. And in the next class, we'll do with the different types of cash crops.